Hi everyone, so we're finally here, 1000 days of the chain link ICO. 1000 days ago on this day, or exactly 1000 days prior to our this, but yeah, 1000 days ago, Chainlink released their ICO, a two-man team with absolutely nothing, no white paper, no and nothing else, and suddenly they get $32 million, which is double the amount that Ethereum's ICO raised, right? That's pretty cool. And it was 19 September 2017. Pretty cool. I know a lot of people who were in the ICO, and the minimum requirement, the minimum amount you could buy through the ICO was 100 Ether. Right? That's an insane amount of money. Back then, Ether was like hundreds of dollars, right? So, yeah, it was like an elitist project right from the start, but a lot of people got together from a lot of different forums and Telegram groups and Discord and this and that. And they pooled their money together to buy into the ICO. It was just 11 cents then. I wasn't in the ICO. I bought it from decentralized exchange, which existed back in the day. Before Fort Delta, there was this other exchange called Ether Delta. And now that exchange is corrupted. It's not like supposed to be used now because there's something wrong with the smart contract. But back then, that was the main like decentralized exchange. There weren't even any other DEXs as far as I remember. Maybe there was DDEX, I don't really remember that much. Now DDEX has, what, like KYC or something? Yeah, but yeah, back then that's where I bought it. I bought Link and I bought Mysterium. And Mysterium is 99% down, as Link is, I think, 2500% up or something like that, even after falling this much, right? And if you compare to the ICO prices, which was just 11 cents, then yeah, it's up a lot. It's up 3500%, something like that. It's $3.5 right now, right? I think, yeah. Yeah, it turned out great. Chainlink is the only coin, only ICO from 2017 among the thousands and thousands that existed back then, which is not 99% down, right? Like Mysterium, for example, it's 99% down, but Chainlink isn't. Chainlink is actually several times above its 2017 ETH, which I can't even say that about Ripple or BSV, right? None of those, well, BSV didn't have like an ICO, but yeah, you get what I mean, right? All these scams, like Ripple and this and that, they are not even anywhere near their 2017-2018 all-time high, while Chainlink is several times above that. That's just what shows you how robust this project is. I'll make a few other videos today about Chainlink, so keep tuned. But yeah, that's basically it. Just wanted to celebrate 1000 days of Chainlink, holding Chainlink through all the FUD, all the this, all the that, you know, all the dumps, like the dump from like over a dollar to just 17 cents. It was 17 cents for so long. I remember there were just memes about Sergey being like this, 17 cents, now that's gangster. Like there were fake articles. People wrote fake articles about how Sergey was in a car crash. And yeah, like so many things happened. Back then it was just a two-man team. And back during the ICO, there was no white paper. And I found out about Chainlink after reading hundreds of white papers. I was just looking desperately for something that could be the next Ethereum, could be the next Bitcoin. And I found a video from this channel called Crush Crypto. And they did an ICO review. And that channel is dead now for some reason. I don't know why. Maybe they already made it. I don't know. But yeah, that's the channel that started out for me. I just had it in my recommended. And I clicked on it and I checked it out. Then I read the... Well, there wasn't a white paper back then, so. But yeah, it was in my mind, and then everybody else was talking about it too. And then when the white paper was released, maybe then I read it. I don't even have a very clear memory of what happened back then, because so much time has passed, right? 1000 days is not a short amount of time. I know people who were in the ICO and they say even they don't remember everything. It's just so bad. Like it was everywhere in the DEXs, this, that. Like there were smart contracts that people made to purchase Chainlink. 100 ETH minimum fee, this, that. You know, guys, like, it's been a long time, and I think our community is the best, where everybody is supportive of everybody, and everybody at least knows what Chainlink does, right? If you ask people what Ripple does, half of them don't know what it does, because it's a scam, it doesn't do anything, right? Yeah, like all these other scams. I'm just so happy that this one didn't turn out to be a scam. I was right about this. Thank you for watching the videos. I recently joined Twitter and a lot of people are following me there. So I do post there quite often. I make original memes and post there. So if you want to follow me on Twitter, it's at Palatine of Facts. I'll link it down below too. So yeah, that's basically it. I think good things are coming, because as far as I can see, the banks aren't really holding very strong here right now. All the governments are printing money, all the governments are trying to save the banks, but the companies are going like insolvent, right? Because nobody's working, there is no new capital being generated, no new money, no new actual financial energy being generated. Because of that, right now, even though they are printing money, shops aren't open, so there is no velocity in money. But as soon as people start spending money, banks will have to pay the toll for that. And yeah, I think we will see some wide-scale withdrawal restrictions all over the world, and we will see capital flight into gold, Bitcoin, and of course Chainlink. But yeah, Chainlink is what companies are going to buy. If you are on Twitter, you can see people post breadcrumbs all the time about how Oracle is going to do this and that, and just there are so many there are so many breadcrumbs that I don't even remember all of them. Even after 3 years, there's something new I see every day. So yeah, that's basically it. Just enjoy, keep holding, and if you can, buy the dip. I don't ever really sell Chainlink. I've never sold even one single token. So I don't really care about the price that much, but it is dumping right now. And I do constantly buy every now and then whenever I can. So yeah, right now is looking like a good time to buy. So that's basically it. Thank you for watching the videos. Take care. Stay safe. I'll see you in the next one. Yeah.